Hello and welcome to this brief video covering how to migrate from telephone verification to Starling 2-factor authentication within Password Manager. The first topics provide a review of telephone verification and an introduction to Starling 2FA. We then look at configuring the Starling 2FA subscription key within Password Manager. Next, we cover coexistence options, where users have the option of using either telephone verification or Starling 2FA when resetting their password. We finish with the cutover, where telephone verification is removed and replaced with Starling 2FA for all password reset workflow. When starting a workflow containing phone-based authentication, Password Manager checks whether the phone-based authentication service is enabled in the provided license. The workflow is executed only if the service is enabled in the license. On the self-service or help desk site, a user selects their preferred phone number and verification method, SMS or automated audio call. This data is sent to the Password Manager service. The Password Manager service gets the phone numbers from the Active Directory attributes specified in the workflow settings. The Password Manager service generates a verification code and transfers the code, the selected phone number, and the verification method to the telesign service. HTTPS is used to send the data. The generated verification code is stored until the workflow has ended. Only one code is stored at a time. The telesign service sends an automated audio call or SMS to the user's mobile phone with the verification code. The language of the automated call depends on the user interface language of the self-service or help desk site. The user then enters the verification code on the website. Then the code is sent to the Password Manager service. The Password Manager service checks the verification code. If it is correct, the user is granted access to further steps of the workflow. Starling 2FA provides the same capabilities with the addition of push notifications or direct token entry through the Starling 2FA app. A Starling 2FA subscription key must be added to the Password Manager configuration to allow Starling 2-factor authentication within a workflow. On first use, users must confirm their mobile phone number to be used for Starling 2FA in their profile. The default value is populated from the mobile phone number entry in their Active Directory profile. You should note that Starling 2FA requires a plus sign and country code at the beginning of the phone number. Starling 2FA generates a verification code and sends an automated audio call or SMS to the user's mobile phone with the verification code. Alternately, the user could request Starling 2FA initiate a push notification to the Starling 2FA app on their mobile phone. The user enters the verification code on the website or clicks approve from within the mobile app. If the authentication code is correct or the push approval is submitted before the request expires, the user is then granted access to further steps in the workflow. Let's look at the workflow to reset an account password using telephone verification. After finding her name, Mary selects Forgot My Password and is then prompted to select a phone number and the method for receiving the authentication code. After clicking Next, she is prompted to enter the code. The code is sent to her mobile phone as a text message. She then enters the verification code into the text field and clicks Next to continue with the password reset workflow. She then enters the answer to a verification question before moving to the screen to complete the password reset. The new password is entered and confirmed while Password Manager performs various compliance checks on the new password. After clicking Next, the password reset is complete. Now let's look at configuring Starling 2FA. We must first log on to the Starling website at cloud.oneidentity.com and select the 2-factor authentication service. On the dashboard, you will find the subscription key on the right side of the window. Clicking the key button displays the key details. Select the key and copy it. We'll now switch to the Password Manager admin website to add the key to the Password Manager configuration. The configuration is part of General Settings. Clicking on the Starling two-factor tab displays the three fields that make up the configuration. Paste the subscription key into the first field, then enter the email address associated with the Starling subscription. Enter the mobile number with country code in the third field and click Save to complete the configuration. Starling 2FA is now available for Password Manager workflows. As the first part of a coexistence phase of our migration, we'll create a new workflow and call it Forgot My Password, Reset Using Starling 2FA. For the description, I simply copied from the existing Forgot My Password workflow and pasted it into the new workflow and then modified it slightly. Clicking Save creates the workflow shell, which we must now configure. Click on the newly created workflow to edit its configuration. The workflow shell starts out empty, and we move in components from the list on the left. First, we'll drag and drop the authentication with Starling 2FA component. Then we drag and drop the remaining components that make up the standard password reset. Authenticate with question and answer profile. Lock Q&A profile. Reset password in Active Directory. Then in notifications, we'll add email user if workflow succeeds and email user if workflow fails. Now we'll drill into each workflow component and set the configuration where necessary. For Authenticate with Starling 2FA, we see there is nothing more to configure as we already set up the authentication in the general settings. For this demo, we'll keep the default settings for the Authenticate with Q&A profile. We'll also keep the default for Lock Q&A profile. This locks the question and answer profile if a user fails to authenticate after 3 attempts. We'll keep the default settings for the Reset Password in Active Directory component as well. Additional options that are available include allowing users to reset their passwords offline and enabling Enterprise Single Sign-On. The notification components require a bit more configuration to define the subject line of the email message along with the body text and subscription options for the user. You can also include additional languages for messages. Once each component is configured, we'll click Save to complete the workflow configuration. Now let's test our new workflow. We'll switch to the user self-service site and connect as Mary Williams again. Mary now has the new Forgot My Password option to reset using Starling 2FA. When she clicks on the workflow, she is prompted to select an authentication method, either SMS, a phone call, or push notification. Let's first try SMS. A code is sent to her mobile phone. Notice there is a message providing a link to download the Starling 2FA app. We'll now go back to the website and enter the code that was received and click Next. The two-factor authentication is now complete, and the rest of the workflow executes the same as with TeleSign verification, answering a verification question and then entering a new password. Installing the Starling 2FA app is quick and easy. Simply follow the link that was sent via text message. The site recognizes the type of mobile operating system and redirects to the appropriate app store, where you can run the install. After installing the app, a registration code is entered to link the app to the Starling 2FA account. With the app installed, we can use push notifications. Let's try it out. We are still connected as Mary Williams, and we will start the workflow. This time we select push notification. Now we see a prompt on the Starling 2FA app on our mobile phone, where we can either deny or approve the request. Let's tap on approve. And now we see on the website that after the approval, the workflow has advanced to asking us a verification question. After answering the question, we can then reset the account password. With the Starling 2FA app, a user may also enter the response token directly. The token can be viewed by opening the app or by swiping to the widgets page on your mobile device. Simply enter the token in the response field in the password reset workflow. Now we may want to let password manager users know about the changes in advance and during the coexistence phase of this transition. We can accomplish this by adding the display user agreement component to the workflow. We can add to the user agreement message a short note about the changes. Now, when a user starts a password reset workflow, the user agreement message with our notice appears at the start. The last thing to look at in this demo is the final cutover. Here we remove the telesign telephone verification from all workflows. We'll first delete our temporary Starling 2FA workflow. Next, we'll edit the primary password reset workflow. First, changing the content of the notice in the user agreement. Then we'll delete the Authenticate via phone component and replace it with Authenticate with Starling 2FA. Click Save and we're finished. Let's go through a final password reset workflow to confirm it's working. We'll use push notification again. And tap on approve in the Starling 2FA app. Answer the validation question. And finish by resetting the password. With the password reset workflow confirmed, we have one last configuration change, which is to remove the scope of the telephone verification service. We navigate to the Telephone Verification tab under Licensing and click Remove. We then confirm the removal in the pop-up window. Our migration to Starling 2FA within Password Manager is now complete and tested. I hope you found this demonstration useful. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be notified when we add more videos.